White House Eye Monitors begins with Seymour B. London, an American physician and inventor from Florida, who designed the first automatic blood pressure monitor. He created an automated blood pressure machine after finding consent manual blood pressure reading cumbersome. While his materials may have been unconventional, his research technique was anything but. He then tested the device on 400 doctors at a 1965 American Medical Association convention. He demonstrated there was no significant difference from vital sign monitor versus hand-taken blood pressure monitor. As there are individual vital sign monitors, inventors cannot be positioned as a single person as an inventor of a patient monitor. Welcome to Biomedical Engineers TV. Let's start the video and know about the basic of patient monitor. Basically, monitors can be classified as basic vital sign monitors, mid-high-end patient monitors, high-end patient monitors, and clinical support system monitors like transport monitors, central monitors, telemetry, and handheld monitors for the use. Let's begin with basic vital sign monitors. These type of monitors consist of ECG, SpO2, NIVP, and temperature. Basically, these type of monitors are used in daycares, outpatient department in the hospital. The mid-higher end monitors consist of ECG, SpO2, NIVP, respiration, ETCO2, temperature, and invasive blood pressure monitoring. These type of monitors are used in emergency department, ICUs, and OT recovery rooms. It can be also used in cath labs and other recovery areas. The higher end vital sign monitors are consist of ECG, respiration, SpO2, ETCO2, NIVP, temperature, invasive blood pressure, cardiac output measurements, NMT measurements, EEG monitoring, anesthetic gas module interface, and BIS. This monitor has the capability to communicate with other medical devices like IOBP equipment, ventilators, defibrillators, and many more as per the application requirement. These monitors are used in operation theaters. As an advancement in a patient monitoring system, there is one more device that is called remote physiological monitoring. It's a portable device that is extraordinarily mobile and can be operated remotely. Compared to heavy equipment used at home and hospital in a decade past, more devices are much faster, primarily digital and non-invasive, and often combines with several analytical features in a single small device. There is also a special monitoring system which is used for OB-GYN patients for pre-delivery, which is called cardiotocography. It is used for to monitor fetal heart rate, uterine pressure, along with mother's heart rate. The monitoring is done by toco and ultrasound. As we reached at the end of the patient monitoring classification video, in next video, we will discuss about the parameters and their definitions. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.